What Are We Prepared to Fight For was the cover of an Economist magazine 2 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. What are we prepared to fight for?
We are prepared to fight for the interests of our country. Now, when you say, or you question, Economist or any other publication or individual, what are we prepared to fight for? Does that equate to going back into another 13 years of war? There are variations of that question. The things that we're doing today, Charlie, certainly not complying at all with some of the narrative out there that somehow we're retreating from the world. The United States military, for example, is in almost 100 countries around the world. We have almost 400,000 military men and women deployed and stationed abroad. We are everywhere. We are connected into everything. Our economic strength and our trade relationships, any measurement you put to where we are, what we're willing to fight for and invest in and what we're doing, we're doing that now. Our interests are clear. We will defend those interests. We will work with our allies, our partners, and as I said, the capacity building, capability building that we're doing now. When I was, as I've already mentioned, I was in the Middle East last week, bringing our GCC defense minister partners as our ASEAN defense minister partners that I did a month ago. These are the kind of things we're doing.
But are they saying, as some of these articles point out, that after the red line in Syria was passed and some other things, that there is a questioning of America's will? When you talk to the people from Saudi Arabia, the king, when you talk to people from the Emirates, when you talk to those leaders who support has been long with the United States. Mm-hmm. They look at what happened in Egypt in the beginning with Mubarak, and they look at what happened in Syria, and these are sometimes are monarchies, obviously. You know. And it has been suggested that they raise questions about America's commitment. Do you hear that, and do you have to reassure them?
Well, yes, I have to reassure, but I don't think that's anything unusual. This is a dangerous, complicated world. If you're a little country sitting out there and you got Iran next to you or China or
Russia, Iran is the thing they worry about.
Yes. They need reassurance, absolutely. And we need to give them that reassurance.